Albert Einstein, you know, wrote a letter, a personal letter to his daughter. They are not stored in his Princeton University in the library. And he wrote a letter to his daughter Leslie. Oh, my dear Leslie, and as you know, the world worships me for invention of law of relativity. You know, law of relativity. But you should know, the entire law of relativity, as of now, if I tell the world will not accept. But I must admit, I must tell you, and beyond the law of conservation of this energy, conservation of mass means law of relativity, and beyond is the law of relativity, and there is some super force, and that super force runs everything. That super force drives everything. And what is that super force? I don't understand how to define it, but it has to be experienced it. And I had a glimpse of it, and the super force, and he named that super force as a, you know, that is called hate, it's called love. Love and brings harmony. Love is nothing but what drives this world and what builds us, what constructs us. And the most powerful force that runs the universe is love. And again, the love whoever works, and he is evil, he causes destruction and he is damage. Love is the most powerful thing that drives everything. And I realized that, that's why, oh my dear daughter, I love you. Look for that letter and Albert Einstein letter to his daughter. You will get exactly the letter what I told you. It only talks about the love. Love. Love means what? Harmony. Be in harmony with others. And means that happens only when you love. When you love. When you love, love beggars love. And the reason why you are getting affected means, so the problem is yours. Every action has a reaction. And problem is you. Problem is because you have hatred in you and it's bouncing back on you. If you only love, love bounces back on you. As you sow, you reap. And suppose I want a sweet mango fruit in India, because India is very famous for mangoes, you know. Now it's the season. Now we are not able to go out and select our mangoes. And it's the beginning. Coronavirus has deprived us of even a tasting mango. And we are afraid because when we eat a mango, our throat chokes. Our throat chokes and the nose sneezes for many of us. The beginning mangoes of the season, very dangerous. Yeah. That's why now looking at a mango and tongue says eat it. But now Corona says, hey, I'm going to make a feast. Now the between Corona and tongue, and Corona is winning. We are not even afraid of buying a mango, I tell you. Because the moment you eat first seasoned mango, and definitely it causes heat, it chokes your throat, it changes your voice, and you sneeze, and then problem is, now you sneeze, and your throat chokes, now drone will be examining, you know. And how you're doing, neighbor is examining, your own family members look at you, oh my God, he is sneezing, and you know, so you try to even go to near to your wife, suppose she's sneezing, or your children are sneezing and coughing, and you get afraid now to go. Now, in fact, the coronavirus made us, and now you are walking on a street, someone, even without sneezing, cough, oh my God, is coming close. Already we were like that. Now, I don't think, and a human will not doubt another human now. What corona created is evil. What it created? It created the doubt. It created the suspicion. And now you won't believe anyone around you. Someone coming near to you, even to hug, oh my God, no, no. Even, so say your girlfriend now sneezes, and your girlfriend, hey, come on, let us hug. Oh, no, 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 my dear, love is late. You know, come on, let me survive first. Let me survive first, let me live, and then love comes. You know, if I die, where is the love? All my love is to live, you know, for my own living. Hey, don't come. Hey, I will also die with you. Come on, you know, sneeze on my face. Let us chum. Let us chew each other. And, you know, so let us kiss each other. Let us hug each other. And let us die, both of us die. Do you think anyone takes the decision? I'm just trying to tell, love. Love is nothing but staying in harmony with the surroundings, staying in harmony with the people around you, staying in harmony with everything around you by which you are nurtured. It's not that you are doing a great job by loving. Because of all of them, you are surviving. Love is the expression of gratitude. That's all. Expression of your humility. And hatred is expression of ego. Disharmony. Love is expression of harmony. And a person understands, I love, I develop. You don't have to meditate. And of course, the hatred temperament is there, they have to. And that's the reason Buddha used to teach when the monks come. And monks come with a lot of arrogance, egos and so many things. And first what Buddha teaches them is the love. And in Tibetan monasteries, first 3 years, and their culture itself is a loving. Oh evil come in, oh goodness go out, let me take all the evil, let me suffer of all the evil, but let the world be happy, let the world be good, let the world be in peace, let the world be free from the disease, let me suffer on account of others' happiness, no problem. That is the sacrifice, that is the love. And this Albert Einstein, anyone sensitive at the peak of science, and one understand the principles of saint, principles of modus operandi of the nature, and Albert Einstein realized, hey daughter, I can 100% tell you, now I love you. Because I experienced the love which drives everything. Which drives everything. What drives? The logic which is in harmony. That's why a bird is in harmony with the nature without questioning. And without a penguin is in harmony with the nature, a dolphin is in harmony with the nature, a tortoise is in harmony with the nature, they are becoming adaptogenic, they are surviving. And we, human also, should be like that. We should adapt, accept. Love is we are in harmony. If we are in harmony, and if you want to be in disharmony, if you don't accept what is around you, you try to modify yourself, mean you are creating a disharmony from the nature. And one of the reasons why virus is created, and why a pig is becoming a carrier of a virus, or why a bat is becoming, because now the research is going on, established research is going on, that people are eating, and so in China, people crave for, and all the now, the people having money means not ordinary beef, not ordinary chicken, not ordinary chicken, not ordinary things. They are looking for zoonotic trade. What species is not available, that meat becomes very expensive. That's why species are extinct, because the people are trading them. And even that one or two species, what have left out, now it is. And people want to relish the taste, and the billionaires, and that's why. And what happens is, and the species which protect the environment, and the problem is, when you bring this chicken, when you bring this goat, and the way you slaughter, the way you keep them caged, the dogs, when you cage the dogs, before you kill them, because you bring from the market, and from the market, when you get these animals from the producer, and when a trader is selling them, the transition for that animal is a torture. The transportation is a torture. The transportation is a torture. And the way they are caged until it is killed, and it is a torture. They are deprived of the food, they are deprived of everything, and they know they are going to die. And those animals undergo enormous amount of suffering, and that's the way they produce this bacteria. And the suffering of these animals, and the torturing those animals, and depriving those animals, and those animals, instead of producing a goodness, and they become carriers of this evil, or they produce this virus. Understand? And that's why a sensible person, first of all, what he has to do? He has to stop, you know, the zoonotic trade, you know, eating any species for human. That's why it is not, you know, it is contempt. You know. And the one which eats the ants and you want to eat that, you know, so you are forgotten. No, you have come from you are doing a carnivore eating another carnivore, and the result is virus is generated, a disease is generated. That is the root cause. That's why I tell you, never eat. In the law of nature, carnivore doesn't eat carnivore. How come a human will eat a carnivore? The entire inflammatory disease is because a carnivore eating another carnivore. Understand? The origin of the virus and principle. We are forgetting what drives the world is consciousness. The consciousness is called love, and love is nothing but a harmony. And for our own survival, and because of all these people we survive, we get. And how come we don't love? Because of you I am surviving, and because of those air I am surviving, because of that earth warm I am surviving, because of that bird which carries the pollen, I am surviving. Because of the insects, I am surviving. You know, because of the sun, I am surviving. And because of you, I have this shirt. Someone is making for me. And how come I will dislike any of the? How come I think I am great? How come I can hate anything around me that nurtures me? It is called cruelty. Anything that nurtures you and you hate it and you dislike it, you try to kill it. You know, so that is called a cruelty, you know, and that's the result. What happens at the nature when in the disharmony and your body in disharmony? The other day I told you, and when someone's life is threatened and he becomes a terrorist, you know, and when an animal is threatened and it becomes indirectly terrorist because carrying a deadly virus against us. Understand? The fundamental laws of nature. Law of relativity is all about observer. It is all about observer, the object of observation. This is what scientists discovered. Object of observation in spirituality is called a drishya. Where you are entered, grahitru, unconscious mind. And is all the way you look at is a problem. Is all relativity. It is all relativity. Position of observer and the position of object is a relative to each other. That's all. That's why it's called law of relativity. In a nutshell, to understand. And spirituality is all nothing but the way you observe, object of observation. What you observe, observation. Spirituality is nothing but methodology of observation, of the object of observation, and you are training this observer. And so what to observe, the field of observation, the law of relativity, a law of conservation of energy, is how to achieve, how to make entropy zero, ego zero, and your problem is solved. This is a fundamental way to look at the law of relativity. Simple. You know. So as I told you, E is equal to mc square is a law of relativity. C is a velocity of the mind. Consciousness is called velocity of the mind. It is not increasing, but it is decreasing. Velocity of the mind. If you are going upward, concentration method, that is called increasing. And mass only increases. Understand? That's not the way to do it. And the way to do it is, and C is a constant, so samadhi is a constant, concentration is, so E can never become zero with the C, because C is a constant. All of us, we know, C means constant, consciousness is constant, always understand. Even eighth samadhi is a maximum constant, below that there is no. So mass is dependent on consciousness, and mass is dependent on consciousness and ego. Consciousness is a constant. You can change it from low level to high level. But you can't, it won't, it only relatively affects the mass. But what, if the mass has to become zero, means the only way is E has to become zero. Only by making, because since you have C is a constant value, and the only option you left, if you don't want to have mass, this is a field of mass, and your E has to become zero. E is nothing but energy. Entropy has to become zero. That can only happen when observer, and through the method of observation, observes the object of observation and removes the duality. Duality means everything is like this, and when he makes it flat like this, the result is over. Simple. The observation is to make this into this. That's all. And then everything changes. So in a simple words, this is what, that's what Einstein is expressing. And what drives this is, and what drives this is object of observation. And the way you look at the observation, the duality is removed, and there's a flat curve, the flat line, and that is a super force. There's a force of love, and there's a force of passion, anger. You can take your breath pattern, your heart pattern, your brain pattern, they're always like this. Distortion. And if you are in harmony, they are like this. For a yogi, they are like this. There is no duality in it. That's what Krishna is telling Arjuna. Pranapanav samav krutva. Your breath becomes equal, flat. So, this is the science behind it and understanding this.